All right, it's August 14th, 2017. My lens is fogging up here again. It's very humid out here after being in a very cool house. Friends at Heirloom Solutions sent me some seeds, and I can't do this with one hand, so hopefully this will come out. Bean Fendi Bengal. Milkweed, which I need to get these out today. And then runner cannelli bean, which I wanted to order that before. I think I ordered some once before, but I don't know what happened to them. I appreciate them. Heirloom Solutions are great people in cooperation with other people. I bought that solar generator when that's the panel for it. I wiped the lens again. And then I got $100 worth of seeds per year for 10 years, which has been a godsend. I've been able to get fresh vegetables, quality heirloom vegetables. And they'll grow forever, basically. You know, you go and buy your stuff at China Mart or some of the other stores, and they might grow half well, half not. These, every seed I've planted, this year is the first time that it hasn't been exact, but still, it's been 95%. I plant one bean, I get one bean plant. But the weather out here has been very tricky, this year especially. My lens keeps fogging up, I see it, because of the humidity. But I'm having challenges with some of them, and these beans are gonna be helpful too. I got a lot of purple hull peas out here I've been planting, and they're coming up. And then I've been planting the Trailer Tears Cherokee. But with these here, I won't even try to pronounce the name. I don't know. Let me see if that's coming out. Okay, those right there. It's like a green bean. I got spots, so I'm going to put some down right there and right there. That gives me about 9 feet going back, and there, that gives me about 14 feet. And I don't know where else. I mean, right here even, too. See, I look at all these holes from previous things that have been put out here over the last 4 years. And most times I dip push stuff down, and then they don't grow because, I've been showing you in the earlier videos how the leaves turn yellow on me and all this because of the ground. I don't put any minerals in here other than PROTOGROW, and that helps a lot with the plants. But I'll have three holes, that one there with two of these, that one there with two of these, and that big one right there for two of them. Got a Waltham watermelon off of this plant here, and look at all the new leaves on here. It was looking, if you see, it looks like it's dying off, and then it got all this new fresh growth on here with flowers on it. And I misspoke and said about a watermelon back here. It was a cantaloupe. And we ate one, and we got two of them over here and ate them. Still got some in the refrigerator. Last night, we had a possum or a raccoon get out here. This one, I should have got this off yesterday. My wife said something about it, and I thought, I thought these were a little differently. I thought these were, at one time, I thought they were sugar baby watermelons because I was looking at the skin on it. But no, these are cantaloupe. Those are honeydews. And then we got some more right here. This should be the sugar baby watermelon. You can see that one in there. If that's not a sugar baby watermelon, it might be also like this here, this cantaloupe. So, and then there's my purple hull peas, my Tobias bean. See the leaves on there? Up around this middle part here, the walk in between the walkway here, the plants are hard to grow and the seeds are really hard to get in the ground. I tilled it up 2 years ago. I didn't sow up. Last year we tilled up that one and that one over there. Put the plastic bag down and it came out okay. This is a purple hull pea plant. The okra plants again. One here. One there, one there. Two there. There's a burgundy okra on the left and a green okra on the right. Plant over there, but this is the purple hull pea. This is what they look like right as they're getting ready to, dry out a little bit. I've been letting them dry out on the stem and then take them off. There are some I've pulled off that were not quite dry. They were moist, but they'll dry off in the house. But they get up pretty tall here, and they get quite a bit on them. So, like I say, right now there's one, two, there's four about this size out here. That one, and two over there. And then that one there is growing. And then those fresh beans, the fresh leaves I was showing, I planted two. And they'll be coming out in the next couple weeks, 3 weeks. Right here is two. Something that came in the garden here and got to that cantaloupe and knocked that one over. So then I put this little short fencing, made it into a circle. See right there? There. There. And then right back there again. And on the end, there's two, three. One on the very far end. One right there. Zoom in a little bit there, right there. And one right there at the end. So those are purple hull peas, so they'll look like this right here. Be big bunches too, which would be really great. But I'm gonna definitely get these planted in here. I'll have six of these planted, two in a hole. And then the milkweed I'm gonna plant over by the house, the plastic that's over there. This is a very good Isaiah 48. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of God stands forever. It's kind of like heirloom seeds. You know, it's a scent from God. You know, it gets you what you need over and over. See, this is what I made these fencing for. Everything out here is homemade, by the way. I took some fencing, it was 4 foot, cut in half. So I made 50 foot roll into 100 foot. Used tomato steaks, put them through the wiring, and make my little fences. And then I was an idiot, and I kept putting them down low and having the tomato stick up high above the fence. And I realized, well, that doesn't make no sense. I should do it the opposite way and have the fence up higher, which is what they do, because they kept crawling up the end post. And I haven't crawled, and look and see how they're going across. It's only been taking me like 4 years, 5 years to learn to do that, but see, now they're going on the fence like a regular fence. So, same thing over there. Now they're all growing like regular fences, and that just, like I said, it took me 5 years to figure that out, because they were just going straight up the first post, the tomato stick, like that right there. You know, and I had that low to the ground, and then it would come all the way up to the top, and it would just hang like that one there. But see how I put string over there to help it go back down to the fencing? That's still too low, but it was already intertwined into that fence, so I just left it like that. And I tried to invert all the other fences back up, at least about 18 inches off the ground. Instead of like 3 or 4 inches off the ground. But yeah, thank you again, Heirloom Solutions. I appreciate it, I really do. We'll have a good harvest this year. Thank you. Heirloom Solutions, folks, heirloomsolutions.com.